Hi everyone, so today I'm going to be doing an unboxing and a time lapse for one of the Inktober collection. So the Inktober collection is a special box that is outside of the subscription. It's a one-time fee for this box and it is a lot larger than the typical ArtSnacks box. And the regular ArtSnacks box is around this size. So in this box there are 8 items. This box is specifically for Inktober. Every day they would do a drawing or some sort of ink piece strictly using inks. And they would do this every day of October. For this specific box, we actually got a standard size candy. This time it was Airheads. It also comes with this sheet of paper that is like the bookmark in the regular ArtSnack boxes. It has a retail price or description of each item. And also has a calendar of October for anyone that wants to try the Inktober challenge. I personally am going to try to do the Inktober challenge. I'm not very good at drawing daily, let alone with mediums that I'm not really familiar with, like inks. I'm familiar with pens, like standard technical pens, but this box came with a lot more than that, so we'll see how it goes. I'm going to try my best to do it drawing every day, if not more than one drawing. We also have this card here, which is a print of a piece done by Jake Parker and a letter on the back. Jake Parker is the founder of Inktober, and as one of the items in the box, there is a free class online lesson from Jake Parker. There's one limited edition item in the box, and it is this custom Inktober sketchbook that's done by Denik. And literally while I was talking about this sketchbook, the sticker fell out. Here is the Inktober sticker for ArtSnacks. I thought I didn't have it in the box, it just turned out it was stuck inside the sketchbook here and I didn't see it. So here it is. Anyways, you can see that it has the logo here on the side. It's a spiral bound 7x9 inch sketchbook, and the pages inside are pretty sturdy. They're thicker than your normal printer paper, which is great because it'll be better in holding the inks in without bleeding through all the pages. The first ink-related item that I'm going to show you in the box is this Copic Multiliner SP pen. So this is more of a technical pen. Here's the tip right here. This is a 0.3 size tip. It has waterproof archival ink. It's refillable and it's meant to last a lifetime since you can refill the ink inside. It's made out of aluminum and it can be used for quick drawings just as well as final drawings. It is possible that other people that receive this box have gotten different sizes. This staff favorite is the Pentel Pocket Brush Pen, and it also is listed as one of Jake Parker's favorite tools also to use when he's doing his ink drawings. This pocket brush pen has a nylon bristle tip, and it can give you really fine lines as well as very thick lines. It also gives you very expressive lines because of the brush tip, and it all just depends on your hand control and the pressure that you use. Next we have the Kudatake Zig Cartoonist Sumi ink, and it's a jar of ink. It's 60 milliliters and it's black inks, and it takes about 5 to 10 minutes for it to dry after you're done drawing with the inks, but it doesn't smear and it doesn't lift if you're doing erasing after it is dry. If you want to add color to your drawings after using this ink, it is suggested to use alcohol-based markers to prevent smearing and bleeding and things like that. So the most expensive item in the box is this Princeton Kolinsky Sable short-handled brush. This is not nylon or synthetic bristles, this is Kolinsky Sable hair. On the tip, the size that I received is a size 4 brush. So this tip right here is supposed to actually hold a really good amount of ink or liquid if you're using it for watercolor or something else. And this brush's retail price is over $29. Next is the Kudatake Zig Cartoonist Nib Holder. It holds the nibs of the pen inside the circle part here. It even gives you a link right here to see how to properly assemble this pen without hurting yourself, because you can really hurt yourself if you poke yourself with the nibs that you're putting in here, and you can also break this, so you don't want to do either of those. So as you probably guessed, the last item in the box are nibs. So this is the Kudatake Zig Cartoonist pen nibs. So as you can see, they're really sharp, and you definitely don't want to poke yourself, but you also want to make sure that if you have kids around, that they don't get a hold of these because they can really hurt themselves with this. And just be careful when you're using these. There's even a warning on here in yellow. Warning! To clean this, you just take these out of the holder and you use soap and water. So next I'm going to be doing a demo using all the products that are in the box, including the sketchbook. I will also try to do the Inktober challenge as much as I can, but I probably won't be able to record every single day that I do the challenge, a time-lapse video of the piece that I made. So whenever I do get to record it, I'll definitely post it. And probably at the end of the month, I'll do a short sketchbook tour of all the pieces that I did during Inktober, just so that you guys can see all the ones that I didn't record and what it looked like. So that'll be coming out at the end of October, if you're interested. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you enjoy the time-lapse. Thanks!